Oops. I don't know why I did that. Okay, well, welcome everybody. And y'all feel free to stop me if you have a question. Since it's a small group, we can, your questions will probably be applicable to anybody that joins or listens to this recording afterwards. So we're excited about the Walk for Alopecia. We hope you are too. It's going to take place on September 30th. Hopefully, people walking where they are, as well as in San Francisco. And NAFT is really happy to bring this walk to the community, and hopefully we'll get bigger and better as we move along. So I know y'all know this because I think you're all registered, I believe. But we are starting this inaugural walk and for alopecia, and the first walk will take the official site will be in San Francisco where NAFT started. About 3 decades ago. And we wanted to offer people that are living not in San Francisco a way to participate. And so we're offering up for people to have teams wherever they are and walk where they are. And this is also this walk is about awareness, but it's also about raising money for NAFT's mission. And our goal is to raise $400,000. I will tell you that we're really doing well so far. It doesn't reflect it on our website, but we're over halfway to this goal, which is super, super exciting. So walk where you are. Teams. These are teams of, or individuals, small teams. You can have 50 people or less. And you just walk in your community. Register, you want to register yourself, register all your walkers, and meet up somewhere safe in your neighborhood. You can meet at your house and walk in, on the sidewalks, a mile around the block, or you can meet in the park, have a picnic, and people can walk at their own leisure, or you can walk together on a path, however you feel like it would be conducive to your team walking together and meeting up. We're saying everyone bring your own water bottles, keep it super simple and casual. You can also go all out if you want to have people meet at your house and, bring donuts, someone brings coffee, or, people can bring picnic items and share to make it fun, take a frisbee. It can really be a picnic or anything you want it to be. The San Francisco walk will take place in the morning. And of course, that walk will have food and a kids area. It'll be a full-blown walk event. The other thing we really hope people do, and we'd love for you all to do, is the walk is September 30th. We want to really blast social media with awareness. And that means, taking a picture of your team and posting it on any of your favorite social channels or a video, make a video. Or if you're in that age group and you want to do a TikTok and do a dance and post it too, that would be great also. But we really want to flood social media on September 30th with all the folks that are walking where they are, as well as in San Francisco, we'll be doing the same thing. And keep it simple, keep it simple. Because if you plan a big giant event with tons of people, that gets really complicated. So we would just encourage you to keep it simple, gather your friends and family and walk and have a good time. So let me stop there. Does that make sense? And do y'all have any questions? Is that what you were thinking?
It makes sense. I do have a question though. Will you have media presence at your walk
Is
to
it?
like the stations and all that, or
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
so will you have like t any local TV stations if you
At the San Francisco walk?
Yeah.
Possibly. We'll certainly try to do that, but we're really relying on social media.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Any other questions before I move on?
Nope.
Okay, cool. So all of you guys are registered, right?
Yes.
Yes, that's what I thought. So what do you do after you register? You obviously know you have a fundraising page. And to what? So after you register, you get your own fundraising page. And we really, really, really encourage you to customize that. Put your picture. There's a message already on there, but you can change that message and write your story, because sharing your story is incredibly powerful. It's a lot more powerful than that standard message that's up there. And so we really encourage you, put a picture, share your story. It's powerful for people to know. They probably don't know all the details of your story if you share it more widely, and it can be really powerful. The other thing we really encourage you to do is set a fundraising goal. And I'm going to share a sample goal in a minute, but you want to put a fundraising goal up there because people will want to know, you know, what you're trying to raise. And so that's really important. And then make a plan to reach that goal, and we'll help you. I'm going to talk through some ideas on this call. And then, of course, you want to invite your friends and family and your colleagues, if you have a work colleagues, to walk with you, like sign up to walk with you, and or make a donation to your team. So I wanted to show you a page. This is someone's page that's already raised quite a bit of money currently. This is Team Leah, and they did a little customization. You can see why they're walking. They didn't do a full customization. And they set a fundraising goal. Their goal is 5,000. They're almost there. And so pretty cool. So you can put your picture and then, you know, your goal. And then you can also put updates. This is an update on their page. So they got a lot of donations, so they wanted to do a quick update to their friends and family that have donated to them. And it's a sweet message, you know, thanking all their supporters. And she is so cute. yeah, she's really cute. So when you update your page, you also get your own page link, a link that you can send out that people click on, and it's super easy for people to donate to your team. So this is a sample goal, just a sample, okay, of how you could raise money. You can make a self-donation first, be the first to donate to your own team, and that could be, you know, $50, $100, $200, whatever you want to donate to your own team. And then we really encourage you to send an email out to everyone you know. Like, don't discriminate, just send it to everybody. Don't think, oh, they're not going to donate, or oh, they're not going to want to walk with me. You never know what people will do. So, you know, send it out to everyone you know. And that email really should be about why you're walking, why you want to walk, why this is important to you. And I encourage you to, again, put a picture. Picture says 1,000 words without saying it, right? So send an email to everyone you know with your page link. Yeah.
Can I make two suggestions too?
Please.
I would post your link on your Facebook page if you're on Facebook, because people that you haven't talked to in 25 years will probably donate. And also, I've had good luck texting my link to people who often check their email. So,
yeah, the text is a good one. Yes, thank you. So I just put a sample here of what's possible. Typically, a team or someone that sends an email can raise $3,000. And, you know, that sounds like a lot of money, and it is. But you just, people want to support you. They're going to want to support you. Also, you want walkers on your team. So walkers also have a story. If they're connected to you, they have their own alopecia areata story. And they can share their story to their network. So if you get walkers on your team, they'll also send an email in that, and they can raise their own money. So I just put, for example, here, I put 5 walkers that raised $300. You know, that'd be $1,500 that you could raise for your own team. I also put on here a lunch and learn. A lot of places where you work will allow you to do a lunch and learn where people bring their own sack lunch or whatever, and you share about what alopecia areata is and what it's like to live with it to a group. You know, that's educating, it's awareness, and then, you know, you can ask people to contribute if they are interested in contributing to your team. And again, I just put $400 there randomly, because typically if you had a lunch and learn, you know, you would probably get a few donations. Some people like to have parties or do little things on the side. So I put a summer send-off pool party here, or picnic. You can invite people to a picnic, and as a summer send-off, it could be a swim party. It could be anything you want it to be. And ask for donations at the door or when they come in for your walk effort. You've heard, I'm sure, a lot of people do bake sales at offices and such, and they can raise a lot of money. So you could get a group of people to do some baking items and sell them. And I just put an estimate here of $500. I've seen bake sales raise thousands of dollars, actually. And then this is just a random put on here. Chick-fil-A does do, you can get them to do a percentage of sales for a day. And I put $500. That was me guessing, but typically Chick-fil-A is a pretty busy restaurant. And if you can get them to commit to a percentage of sales, you might get some donations that way. So this goal would be, you know, this person would have raised $6,500. So I think that's, what'd you say?
That was pretty good.
Yeah, it's really good. We already said this, but what to include in your email. Pictures, I can't say pictures enough. Pictures, pictures, pictures. Share what it's like to live with alopecia areata. Be really honest and frank about it. Or if you have a loved one with alopecia areata, share about that. Why you're passionate about walking and your involvement with the National Alopecia Areata Foundation. You could also include a video. If you wanted to do a video message, you could do a video message. That's really sort of the thing. People like videos these days. And definitely include your fundraising link. And then ask people to either walk with you, sign up for your team, or to contribute and support your effort. I already really said this, but you do want to invite people to walk with you, like actually have them register and walk on your team. Again, they have their own network, they have their own story. And so it's great to have them register and fundraise also. And the average walker raises about $500 to $1,000. Just by sending an email out. Hi, Neil.
Hi, sorry.
Welcome. So this is just a recap. The average team raises about $3,000. It's great to kick off your fundraising with a self-donation, and make sure you share your story via email, you customize your page, and have some fun with your fundraising. If you want to do a little side thing, a lunch and learn, or a little bake sale or something like that, you know, have some fun with it. And certainly invite your friends and family to walk with you and register. And we wanted to let you know that there is going to be a cool Walk for Alopecia t-shirt. So anyone that raises $200 will get their t-shirt mailed to them. So that's automated. So as soon as a person raises $200, we get a t-shirt in the mail to you. And we also have a kit for all of you folks that are walking where you are. So any team that raises $3,000 will get this fun kit. It's an awareness kit. It's going to have a Walk for Alopecia banner. There'll be some stickers and these little hand paddles that have Walk for Alopecia on it. Also some tattoos, temporary tattoos, some fun stuff to spread awareness when you walk. And then finally, Chris and I are here to help you. We can help you get your page customized. We can help you write your letter. We can help you with fundraising ideas. We can help brainstorm with where you want to walk, anything you need. We're here to help. You set a plan and have a goal. And that is it. I hope that was helpful, but I'll just open it up. What questions do you guys have? Is there anything you need from us?
Well, I'm all set. I've got my website, you know, up there. I have a meeting tonight, so I'm planning on taking a group picture, depending on how many of us show up. I'm expecting just about four people, but one of them will be walking. One's going to be helping me with the walk, so I'm hoping to just get a good picture tonight.
Nice.
And yeah. I sent a long email out to my group. I think I got a few fundraising dollars from that. A couple of them anonymous, so I don't know who those people are.
Oh, nice.
Okay. And then I did send an email out to friends and family, but I didn't do the link to some of those, the text link. That's what I'm going to do. There's, you know, you got people you're in contact with, but not really on Facebook so much. But I did want to post something on Facebook. I'm not sure how to word that yet, but that's the plan.
Love it.
So
I will say that sometimes people are so busy. And I will say from my perspective, it's always nice for people to ping me more than once. Cause you know, I get an email and then I'm like, okay, I'm going to do that later. And then I forget about it because, you know, we all have thousands of emails, right? Right. And so don't be afraid to send another email or to send a text because people will appreciate it because it just falls off your radar. It's summer, you know, like, and we say do it, you know, 3 to 5 times. I'm still walking. It's, you know, 6 weeks away or 5 weeks away or 4 weeks away. I hope you'll, you know, support my effort, you know, stuff like that.
No, I plan to do that. We were not sure about the walk date because I'm going to be out of town a major part of September already. And so we were going to, you know, make sure September 30th will be the day to walk here.
Cool.
So I didn't put that on my email, but I put like on the webpage, you know, it's a tentative date. So I want to firm that up with everybody because I said, really got that feedback. Well, when you're walking, you didn't put that on there, you know.
Oh.
So they know that a reminder will be coming.
Good, 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 good.
So, and I didn't know about the Chick-fil-A and percentage of sales. We'll see about that. But
yeah.
Small because I've been involved with NAF for 40 years. And we did walks back in the early 2000s for awareness. It's been a while. And the one woman that I'm hoping helped me on this local one, you know, she was the one running those. So for anybody that's doing these, yes, start small. Just have four of you go a mile down one street and turn around and come back and go a different way because it is a lot of work to put on these things. But it's
a
practice for anybody that wants to do something later on, I think.
Yeah.
Very true.
Next year for 2024, you know.
Yes.
But the Chick-fil-A, I never ate at Chick-fil-A's, but I know, that's all right.
It's okay. It's all right.
You know, I guess I could just walk in there and say, would you do this one day, even though
absolutely. Yeah. You can call them too. If there's one locally near you, you know, just pick up the phone and call and talk to the manager and, you know, see if they'll do it. And there's I think there's other restaurants that do that kind of thing too. So it's not just Chick-fil-A.
Well, if you know of any, you know, why don't you send something out to the support group people or whatever, or the people that are doing these things, maybe they know that, maybe they don't. But I was surprised at how many teams you do have out there, but there's quite a few with not even a dollar yet. So I'm sure that's a little bit disheartening, but you know,
No, I think they just haven't gotten started. They signed up early and they're like, oh, we have time to do that. It's in September.
Before they know it already, I know.
Yeah. Tiffany or Neil, do y'all have any questions or thoughts, or can we help you in any way?
So if we do happen to have any kind of local media folks that want to report on this, and do we need to reach out to you and let you know that? Because they might ask questions and I don't know if, you know, we're doing this for NAAF locally, so I didn't know what the process was if that happened
to That's me. A really good question. I guess if you are going to have media come out, it would be good to know. We could sort of certainly arm you with some facts and things that, yeah, some talking points.
Okay. And then also explain the whole Chick-fil-A. How does that work? I'll eat that Chick-fil-A. Idea.
Listen, Chick-fil-A, they will do a percentage of sales, like for one day. Typically, they do it all the time for all different kinds of things. And I would say, you know, contact your local store and see if they'll, if they're interested in doing that for you. Tell them what you're doing.
Sometimes there's a form online you can fill out too.
Yeah, that's right.
A form on the NAAF website?
On Chick-fil-A's website.
Yeah. Oh, okay. All right, cool. Okay.
I have a question. So I already got a donation by hand. They were not going to sign up on Classy and do that online. And I expect maybe a few more people. A friend of mine is having computer problems and she wants to mail me a check. Is this just something that should go off, you know, not online to put your donation out there on your page? Is there a different way to do that? Or should I just wait till I get money and just give another donation myself, maybe?
You can do either or. You can mail that to NAAF's address with your, you know, that you're walking with your name, and that'll, then we'll get it credited. Or, Jan, what might be easier is that you just convert it yourself.
Okay. Just deposit the check. Yeah, and just add
they
another
have
donation.
To make the check out to you, though, if you're going to convert it, right? So if it's right. Mailed out to NAAF, you'll have to mail it in.
Oh, right. No, I said someone already gave me cash.
Right. Oh, yeah. Just convert it yourself. You could make a donation and just keep the cash.
Okay. Because yeah. I didn't know online if my donations, like I'm Sterling Heights Strollers on there.
Mm-hmm.
That's my group. So just you said if it's $200, is that when I hit $200, a t-shirt's mailed out to me for my group, or is it a person? I don't understand.
A person.
Per person.
It's per person. If one person raises $200 or more, they get a t-shirt.
But the people donating on my team are
no.
That was them.
No, they have to be a walker that's raising money themselves. So like if the person that gave you $200 was walking and donated that to themselves, they would get the t-shirt.
Okay. All right. So yeah. I just have an anonymous person that went over $200. So they're going to get a t-shirt.
No, they donated to you. No. So no, donors don't get t-shirts. Walkers get t-shirts.
Just the members then.
Correct.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Okay.
And it looks like, Jan, I'm looking at your team on my phone. And it looks like your donors have given money to the team, not to each person.
Oh, that's a walker.
So if you need us to transfer money into your personal account, we can do that.
Oh, no, that's not necessary.
Okay.
The team is good. I'm a team player.
It's good.
Okay, thank you.
Absolutely.
Chuck, I don't know.
Any other questions that we can help you guys with?
I think I'm good for now. I might have some questions after this, but I think I'm good for now. I just need to get started on personalizing my page, I guess.
Great. Well, thank y'all for joining, and please don't hesitate to call Chris or myself or do the walk at NAF.org, and we'll get back to you quickly if you have any questions whatsoever. And thank you. Looking forward to it.
Thank you.
Have a great one.
Thanks for watching.
Bye-bye.